We handled a business disruption because HCL, being a service provider by itself and also being and also servicing a lot of plethora of services to its customers, tends to be dependent on a lot of our telecom vendors. Now, all these vendors obviously send us invoices every month, and they want these invoices to be paid to them within a quick SLA of 3 to 4 days. Now, what we realized was that all these invoices were somewhere getting lost in the system, and therefore, we as employees were not just the affected parties. We felt that we would submit a claim to the company, and the company would take months to reimburse the money back to us. But we also realized that a lot of these invoices, which are coming from the vendors, ended up resulting in some business disruption for us. Not in the true sense, but at least we were staring at business disruption to begin with. So that was one of the biggest problem statements. The second problem statement was, a lot of our vendors ended up getting dissatisfied with us, because while our contract with them said that we would have a credit term of 30 days or 60 days, depending on how big or small the vendor is, we ended up paying them money after 90 to 180 days. And therefore, while we have an industry best DSO of around 55 to 60 days, our DVO, or whatever we pay to the vendors, was touching somewhere close to 100 or 120 days. So somewhere it meant that the processes internally were not working well. A lot of noise was spent because of the fact that since there was no visibility, we did not know where the invoice was. And therefore, whenever there was any escalation, we did not even know whom to get in touch with. So we always went back to the person who escalated, and then we tried to understand that who was the person who ended up initiating the procurement, who was the person who ended up getting the procurement for HCL, and then how do we take it forward to the next level. So all these were problem statements that were staring at us. Now, what was our response? To put it simply, we had to give a brand name to this initiative. We called it Project Neon. Neon, because we said that this project has to give a lot of visibility to all the invoices which are lost in the organization at multiple levels. Now, I don't need to give an introduction about HCL, but HCL is spread across so many geos, across so many entities, and it has 80,000 plus employees across so many cities in India as well, that it became very difficult for us to get in touch with everybody over email or over phone and expect a response from them. So we branded this project Neon, for the simple reason that through this project, more than anything else, we wanted to know where the invoice is stuck so that we could always find somebody whom we could catch hold of and make him responsible for not paying the payment to the vendor. Now, I did mention the issues. The first issue was no accountability. Now, this is a very important point because, I mean, it's difficult for me to reveal this, but the ratio in HCL around PO and non-PO invoices, and I don't have to explain what PO and non-PO is, but the ratio of PO to non-PO invoices in HCL was around 20 to 80. A lot of our PO invoices are just 20%. A lot of our non-PO invoices are 80% by volume. Now, by value, the number is different for sure. It's actually the opposite. But having said that, these small invoices, not more than 1,000, 5,000, 10,000, 50,000 INR or USD, created a lot of disruption in our ways of working. And everybody said that the process does not work. And since I'm part of the business process transformation team, everybody started staring at me. And that is where, like I said, Nugent came to rescue. Now, lack of visibility is something which I've already covered. And then we said that since there was no visibility, we did not know whom to track and how. So obviously, there was a complete mismanagement around reporting in terms of how many vendors are there, how many invoices are there, what is the status of each and every invoice, so on and so forth. So from the issues, obviously, the benefits would sound positive. We wanted a system accountability so that we could say that, yes, this is the person who is responsible for approving the payment to the vendor. Along the visibility, we said that we would have a very strong governance mechanism to catch all of all these people on a regular basis by ensuring that, yes, nobody goes scot-free. And yes, at the same time, since we are getting pretty much late into this process, we said we have to get the best practices. So what did we do? The first thing that we did was we said that the invoices have to come centrally to a location. Now, that was a decision that we would take within HCL. The background is that since there were so many invoices that were floating in the organization, they used to go either in Bangalore or in Chennai or someplace in Sweden or someplace in Chicago. And therefore, all these invoices were not coming into a common mailroom. So the first and foremost thing that we did was we said that we have to centralize our invoice into a common mailroom so that people, there's only one single department that is responsible for receiving the invoices. The second thing that we said was that we have to manage the behavioral aspect of all the vendors, because eventually there has to be one team again who is responsible for managing the vendors within the company. Now, the reason why I'm highlighting this is because all this had nothing to do with the product, but with the fact that HCL itself had to mature itself to adopt a product that Nugent had provided to us. We also said that we would have to move towards a higher PO-based invoicing from non-PO-based. We said that yes, there has to be a simple visibility, not just for the employees, but for the vendors as well, so that a vendor could very simply come, log in, enter the invoice number, and see that, yes, this is where my invoice is stuck. I mean, that's the first thing that always comes to everybody's mind, that why don't you outsource all your non-core financial activities? We said, fine, we'll do that. The second thing that came was that we heard this buzz called cloud. Put everything on cloud. So one was outsource our activities. Second was put everything on cloud. And then the third and the most complicated was outsource, cloud, and at the same time, why don't you make it a service line for HCL? Now, that made it very complicated, because if you're outsourcing something, it becomes a service line for a company like NewGen. How could it become a service line for a company like HCL? So these are the three broad themes that were given to us and said that now you have to make it happen as a part of this product. So the evaluation ended up becoming quite complicated, because we had to decide on outsource versus buy versus build. Build, because we said that yes, we can outsource to somebody, but at the same time, it has to become a service line as well. So what is it that we thought? We said that let us not just look ourselves as HCL Technologies who works in the infrastructure area. Let us not just look ourselves as HCL Technologies who looks after the application division. Let us also try and get in touch with our BPO environment, which is the BPO division, which is the BSERV division. So what we did was, we got in touch with NewGen. NewGen has a ways of working already defined with the BPO division, wherein NewGen and HCL get in touch with the customer on a joint basis to provide them whatever services and processes they want by outsourcing the complete solution within India. Now, this is something that we ended up doing. So we said that yes, we will outsource this process to HCL BPO. So our first theme was met. The second theme was that yes, whatever product we take from NewGen, we will host it on private cloud. So the cloud initiative was met. And the third was that since we're doing it along with our HCL BPO division and NewGen, it becomes a service line for HCL BPO as well. So all these three themes were met as a part of our transformation initiative within HCL.